Good afternoon, everybody. As he said, my name is Kevin Pinta, and I'm a PhD student at the Software Languages Lab of the Vrije Universiteit Brussel. And the research that I'm doing is related to programming language design in general for mobile applications, and in specific for mobile applications that use RFID technology. So the talk today, I would like to talk about two things. The first thing is Morena, which stands for Mobile RFID Enabled Applications. And Morena is a middleware for Android. And the goal for Morena was to make it easier to program RFID applications on Android, of course. And then at the end of the talk, I will also give a sneak preview on the research that I'm currently doing, but which is not finished, of course. So first, RFID in Android. What is the status? Well, RFID technology in Android is adopted through near-field communication, which, as the name says, is a technology with a very close range, up to a few centimeters, but in practice, usually touch range. And so the Android API provides a number of abstractions to work with NFC tags and to write data on these tags. And this is usually done using endf messages. So an endf message is a standardized protocol to organize data and to store it on a tag. And actually, what it is just a container for endf records. And endf records are, in essence, byte arrays. Activities are notified of the appearance of a tag by subscribing to usually a certain MIME type or some kind of external type. And they are notified using the intent callback system. And the Android NFC API provides file access abstractions to store endf messages on tags. So there are methods like open and close and read and write. However, there are a few drawbacks with this API. And the first drawback is manual failure handling. So as some of you may know, reading and writing tags frequently fails. Yes, and actually you should consider these exceptions the rule rather than actual exceptions. So it's enough that the tag is a bit misaligned with respect to the reader, to the antenna of the reader, for an operation to fail. And in many cases, the same operation will succeed shortly after the first failed attempt. So currently, with the Android NFC API, the programmer has to manually protect all the NFC operations with exception handling code, which of course complicates the application code and is not easy to maintain. A second issue is that read and write operations on NFC tags are blocking calls, and that they are slow. Well, slow in comparison to what you would usually do on an activity main thread. So if the programmer is not careful, the application will freeze and will be unresponsive until an operation succeeds or fails. So the Android API recommends to schedule well certain of most of the NFC operations on a different thread than the main thread of the activity. Again, the programmer has to do this manually, and this complicates the application code. A third drawback is manual data conversion. I think this is pretty clear. If you have high-level application data that you want to store on an NFC tag, you have to constantly convert it to and from endf messages, which in essence are byte arrays, so this is pretty low level. And last minor drawback maybe is that there's a tight coupling with the activity-based architecture. So for example, for discovery, you're always tied to this activity, and it becomes sometimes hard to perform NFC operations outside of an activity context. So with Morena, we try to tackle these issues. And in doing so, we have learned a few lessons from earlier research that we have performed. And in this earlier research, we have integrated programming with RFID tags in AmbientTalk. And AmbientTalk is an experimental scripting language, a distributed language, to develop applications that operate in mobile ad hoc networks. And these mobile ad hoc networks, they are characterized by many failures. So it can be, for example, a Wi-Fi direct network in which users move about and the connection is lost, and users come back, so the connection is restored. And it is in this setting, in ambient talk, failures, network failures, are considered the rule instead of the exception. So what we did in ambient talk is modeled RFID tags as true mobile devices and treat input-output on these tags as network communication in an error-prone, in a failure-prone network setting. So what Morena does, and the lessons that we have learned, is that so Morena will model data that you want to write on NFC tags as Java objects, high-level software representations. And these Java objects, we call them things, yeah, because you put tags on things, usually. And they always maintain a unique one-to-one mapping to a real physical NFC tag. These things objects can be stored directly in the tag memory, so there's no need for the programmer to do manual conversion from and to endf messages. It features event-driven discovery, which is not totally new. Android has, for example, the intent callback system, which is also event-driven. And Morena ensures that every operation is automatically asynchronous, non-blocking, and fault-tolerant. So I will explain this later. The Morena middleware consists of two layers. The first layer is what I will start with, and it provides the highest level of abstraction, namely the thing abstraction. So Morena is available, only works with Android 4.0, so API level 14 and up, because it contained a major upgrade to the NFC stack. Before I show you some of the API of Morena, I will introduce a small and simple example application that I will use in the code later on. So this example application is called Swipe and Connect. And the setup is that you just have to swipe an NFC tag that contains Wi-Fi network credentials to connect to this network. So it could be used, for example, in McDonald's, instead of typing the Wi-Fi network and the key that you need to connect to the Wi-Fi network, you just scan a tag and you're connected to the Wi-Fi network. So on the left, you see the list of networks. So if you scan a tag, it is the name of the network is put in the list. You can select one of the networks in the list, and then you can choose to connect to it, create a Wi-Fi joiner, which means that you can store the credentials on a new tag, choose to share it, or remove the network from the list. And if you either choose to create a Wi-Fi joiner or choose to share it with another device, you get this simple user interface, which contains two text fields where you can enter or modify the SSID of the network and the key, the password to the network. If you press create, then you store these credentials as a thing on an RFID tag, on an NFC tag. Or in the other option, if you press share, you will share it to another device in a peer-to-peer fashion using Android Beam. So now for the code. So in Morena, you have to model all the data that you want to store on an NFC tag as things. How do you do this? Well, by simply subclassing the thing class that is provided by Morena. So here we create a Wi-Fi config thing, which contains two fields, of course, the SSID of the network and the key that you need to authenticate to join the network. And so if you store one of these things on an NFC tag, what happens is that this thing is automatically serialized to a JSON format. Well, it is to say all the fields are serialized if they are not declared transient. In the constructor of a thing, you have to pass the activity. You have to pass an activity. And this is a special activity. It's of type thing activity, which is also provided by Morena, and which is parameterized by the type of things that this activity wants to interact with. And once you have passed this activity into the constructor of a Wi-Fi config, you don't have to worry about scheduling things on the right activity thread, et cetera, et cetera. This will be done automatically. So what Morena does is then start to capture all the low-level NFC events from this activity and trigger the necessary actions on associated thing objects. Of course, a thing can also have methods. So a useful method here is the connect method, which forces asks the device to join this particular Wi-Fi config thing. So how do I put an initial Wi-Fi config thing on a tag? Well, Morena provides a special thing activity, as I mentioned before. And in this activity, you just have to override the whenDiscovered method, which accepts as an argument an object of the empty record type. And an empty record type represents an empty NFC tag. And we consider empty NFC tags as NDEF formattable tags, which do not already contain a thing type. So this method is invoked every time a new empty NFC tag is called. And such an empty records object is actually a special thing, which only understands one method, namely initialize, to put the first thing on the tag associated with this particular empty record. So the initialize method, in this case, takes four arguments. The first one is the initial thing that you wish to put on the tag, and two listeners, and a timeout. Okay. And what is important here is that this method is asynchronous, so it's automatically scheduled on another thread, and it will signal success or failure through these listeners. A second thing is that this method is also resilient to failures. So as I mentioned before, pretty often these read and write operations fail, and it's usually enough to retry the operation to make it succeed. Well, this is done for you. So if the operation fails, it is simply rescheduled until it is successful or until the timeout has expired. Okay, so a minor thing is that there exist overloaded versions of this method, so you don't have to specify all the listeners. You can use a default timeout instead of providing all the arguments every time. So once you have things on NFC tags, how do you discover them? Well, again, you override the whenDiscovered method, but this time with a Wi-Fi config, so the type of things that you actually wish to discover as an argument. So this method here will be invoked every time you scan a tag that contains a Wi-Fi config. So what happens is that Morena will deserialize the information on the tag, recreate a Wi-Fi config object, and it provides cached, the fields are cached, are the cached data from the last read of the tag. So you can access, for example, the SSID synchronously on this Wi-Fi config object. So what this code does is every time you scan a tag with a Wi-Fi config on it, you connect to it. Of course, you can also modify things. So as I've said before, a thing is always uniquely associated with a tag. So modifying a thing, you can just do it by assigning the fields with new values. So here we assign the SSID and the key of an existing Wi-Fi config thing. And then you have to manually call the save async method, which is similar to the initialize method of an empty record. So it again takes two listeners, one that will be triggered in the case of success, one that will be triggered if Morena was unable to save the Wi-Fi config to persist it in the memory of the associated tag within the defined timeout. Again, this method is asynchronous. It's automatically scheduled in another thread, and it is fault tolerant. One last method that exists on Wi-Fi config things, or on things in general, is the broadcast method. And the broadcast method will try to share this thing using the Android Beam API in a peer-to-peer fashion with another phone. So, the Beam API is pretty similar to the API for reading and writing text, so it suffers from the same problems. It's a blocking call, it's slow, etc. And so again, this takes two listeners, one that signals success, one that signals failure. And if you broadcast a thing, what it does on the other phone, on the receiving phone, is called the whenDiscovered method with the broadcasted thing, except that this thing that you then discover is not uniquely associated with a tag because it did not originate from a tag. So you cannot you cannot edit it and call save async, but you could use it to initialize an empty record, for example. So we have we did a little evaluation of our middleware. By implementing this example application, first using the standard NFC API of Android, which is in the left picture pictured in blue. And we also implemented it then with using Morena, which on the left picture is depicted in green. And then we took a marker with different colors, and we went over all the lines of code and that are related to NFC and divided them into different subproblems. And the different subproblems that we identified were event handling, for example, discovery, data conversion, failure handling, read and write functionality, so calls to the read and write operations, and concurrency management. And so on the left, you see the total number of lines for each of these categories in the different implementations. What you can observe, for example, is that the total lines of code in using Morena has a reduction of a factor 5 for this application. Of course, this can be different for different applications. What you can also see is that the program is totally freed from concurrency management. Everything is automatically scheduled in the right threads. And on the right, so the right-hand picture shows the percentage of these different subproblems, these different categories of lines of code related to NFC as a percentage on the total number of lines of code. So on the left there, you see the implementation using the Android NFC API. And on the right, you see the Morena implementation. And so what you can see is that actually in the implementation with Morena, the weight of the lines of code shifts to event handling. Where on the left you have 75% of the code related to data conversion, failure handling, read and write functionality, and concurrency management. Well, on the right you have almost 70%, 64% of the code is related to event handling, which is actually a good thing because the event handling is the actual application logic of your application. Also note that while more emphasis is put on the event handling, in total lines of code, the event handling was still less than in the implementation using the Android NFC API. So there's also a lower level in Morena, which is the TAG level, so it doesn't provide a high-level thing abstraction, but it provides it allows you to specify custom serialization strategies, but still provides you with asynchronous and fault-tolerant operations. And how do you use this layer? You do this by subclassing a TAG discoverer class, which is available in Morena. And you have to override two methods, onTagDetected and onTagRedetected. So the first method is called the first time that you scan a particular tag. And the second method is called if you scan a tag that was already scanned. And as you can see, the arguments to these methods are tag references. And a tag reference is a first class reference to a tag, which will provide you with the necessary read and write operations, but automatically asynchronous and fault tolerant. If you initialize, if you call the constructor of an tag discoverer, you have to pass it an activity, you have to pass it a type. So with things, the type was immediately inferred from the class name, while here you can specify manually a MIME type, for example. And you can provide two converter objects to convert the data that you want to write on tags to endF messages and from endF messages. So it's a bit lower level, but it's a bit more versatile. And actually, the TAG reference abstraction is what does all the work. So a TAG reference, of course, is uniquely associated with an RFID tag or an NFC tag. It contains cached data. So every time you read the tag, this data is cached, and you can access it synchronously. And then what is important is that it maintains, so it has its own threat of control, and it maintains a queue of operations that have to be performed. So every time you do a read or a write on this tag reference, this is not immediately performed, but it is rather appended in the queue, and the tag reference is autonomously responsible to process all these operations and signal success to a success to the possible success or failure listeners. So, for example, if the tag is not available, it's perfectly valid to perform a write operation with, for example, a timeout of 20 seconds, and then after 10 seconds you scan the tag, the operation is still in the queue and is waiting until the tag is discovered, and then the read or the write operation is performed. Now, what is also important is that these operations are always processed in the order that they were appended in the queue, so you won't have out of order operations. Then, well, for the API, it's pretty simple. You have a read operation, which again takes a read listener, a success listener, and a failure listener, and possibly a timeout. I omitted it here. And for writing, well, the same, except that you have one extra argument, namely the object of the data that you want to write, and that will be converted using the two converter objects that you provided. One last method that you can override in this tag discoverer class is a check condition, which is invoked when a tag is discovered, but before the onTag detected and onTag redetected methods are called. And here you can inspect the cached data that is available in the tag reference to allow for a more fine-grained filtering instead of only filtering on the based on a MIME type, for example. So, as a conclusion for Morena, it provides event-driven discovery, non-blocking communication with either things, which contain a cached copy of the data, and provide asynchronous saving of this cached data if you modify it, or either with a lower-level abstraction of tag references. It provides automatic data conversion in the, well, in the thing abstraction, and it provides a looser coupling from activity-based architectures. So all in all, if you count this together, we think that it makes it a lot simpler to implement applications on Android that actively write data on NFC tags using Morena. That was it for Morena. And to conclude this talk, I would like to well, give a small feel for the research that we are currently doing. And this research is centered around the vision where, well, the entire environment is pervaded with tags. So tag all the things. So what if every chair contains an RFID tag, or I don't know what? And then, well, a lot of problems with this vision. For example, how do you put data structures over many tags? So if I create an object graph, how can I persist it in the memory of different tags? Can I query these collections of things? So for example, in a library of books, can I query the books? And what happens if I launch a query over, well, 10 books that I scanned, and then I scanned 5 more books, then I have to redo the query? So it causes a lot of problems. Can we provide stronger consistency guarantees? Transactions, for example, so if I would perform a write operation that involves 3 tags, I would like to be able to specify that either all 3 tags are written or none of the tags is written. And so again, we are implementing a sort of library in AmbientTalk, and we're drawing some inspiration from the Active Record library from Ruby on Rails, which I guess many of you will know. But we want to apply it for RFID. So I will show you some code. It's in AmbientTalk, so the syntax might be a little bit weird, but I hope that you get the gist. So what we allow is to define models of things, which is a bit similar to a class of things. So for example, here I depicted the definition of 2 models, one for a shelf of books in a library. It contains a number of properties, which are just fields. For example, the shelf has a number, and the book has a title, authors, and ISBN number, all of them strings. You can also specify a prototype, which is where you can just specify methods. Again, this is nothing special. For example, there is an isMisplaced method on a book, which, if you call it with the shelf, compares the shelf to the shelf associated with this book. I will explain this in a minute. If it's not the same, then it is misplaced, right? And then you can, as in Ruby or on Rails, for example, you can define a number of associations on these things. For example, here we say that, well, a shelf contains many books. And a book, well, it belongs to one shelf, right? And what the definition of these associations do is that they create, as in Active Records, a special set of methods or fields that that you can assign and that will perform some special operations. I will explain it in a minute. First, I just wanted to show how to create a thing object using these models. Well, you have the create method on a model. You fill in the properties with the actual data. And then you have to call a save async method, which is a bit similar to the Morena version, which returns a save request object that you can observe for either success or failure. So and once you have these things, for example, the new book thing, well, there's a, so we defined an belongs to shelf association on the book. So it has a field shelf now that you can assign with an actual shelf thing. And if you do this, what happens is that the foreign key of this of the shelf that you want to associate with this book is stored on the tag of the book. So you could do this also the other way around, because we defined an has many books association on shelves. You can also, using the double less than operator, you can add a book to the set of books associated with the shelf. Again, this will place a foreign key. It will persist a foreign key on the tag associated with this book thing. So this is one thing. Oops. These are the associations. And well, a second thing that I just wanted to show is that we have that this library provides reactive queries. And these reactive queries allow you to perform queries over collections of these things that you have discovered. But these queries are automatically reevaluated if the collection is extended or tags disappear, etc. So for example, easy query is to get the first shelf of all the shelves where the number is 42. So the dot all method on a model returns the collection of all the shelves that have been discovered since you defined the model. So once you define a model, behind your back, the library automatically starts to discover tags and collects all the tags which contain a shelf thing. The same happens with, so you could define the current shelf as the last scanned tag. So both of these methods return a singleton, which is a collection with one element. And the element in this singleton may change. So if you rescan another shelf, well then the current shelf variable will contain a pointer to the same singleton, but with a different element in it. So you could also filter, so well the scenario that I'm implementing here is to find, it's a real scenario, is to find misplaced books, so books that are on a shelf that they shouldn't be on. So here we could define, well, the collection of all misplaced books as a filter on the collection of all the books that we have discovered, where the book is misplaced with respect to the current shelf. So this, what this generates is a new collection that is updated as you scan new books, right? So if I scan 5 more books, the operation will be applied to these new things that I discover, and they will be put in the misplaced books collection if necessary. Also, if the current shelf singleton changes, well, again, this whole collection is updated and containing books that are misplaced with respect to the new current shelf. Last method, for example, is the dot each method, which performs an operation on all the books that you scan, but also includes books that that you scan later. For example, what we do here is we'll synchronize the misplaced books with the shelf that you last scanned. So you apply disclosure on every book item that that is contained in the misplaced books. So you see that this each method is applied on the misplaced books collection. So every time the misplaced books collection is updated because you scan new tags, well, this dot each method is also reapplied to reapply this closure on the, well, the newly appeared book thing. So, well, this concludes my my talk. On the last slide, I have put some of my contact details, and also some pointers to the AmbientTalk programming language. And if you're interested, you can download Morena and the example Swipe and Connect application through the top URL. Thank you. If you have questions.
Questions?